What's up, YouTube? This is Vorpal Blade, and as promised, here's a tutorial on how to make a cannon, Vorpal style. You guys might recognize this from this particular version of our Let's Play, as we have a lot of different saves because we like to archive every now and then. But is there a zombie on the TNT? Oh god. There's a zombie in the TNT. Alright. You might recognize this particular version of it from our joke episode, or rather our April Fool's episode, in which we messed around with cannons, and I promised you guys that I would teach you how to make a cannon that works as wonderfully as this. And today I'm going to show you that. Originally there was a video on YouTube that I saw. I forget the name of the guy. I'll leave a message in my comment box on the guy who came up with this particular design of cannon. He had the idea for a double-barreled cannon in which you could use to fire, like, you know, and you could, like, depending on how well, fire great distances, and you could actually aim it after it was placed. And how he did it was if you would take some of this TNT we have here and you were to load it differently than you did, like, say, like, you loaded this side up pretty heavy all the way, and you only loaded this side very lightly, it would shoot more to the left because there's more force coming from the right side, therefore it shoots it to the left more. I'll give you a demonstration. I'll go ahead and click that. That should pop up and shoot it more to the left. See? And wow, that goes out of draw distance. This is a powerful cannon. But the power not only comes in from the ingenious design that this guy came up with, but also in the timing. You see, I'm going to load this up once more, and I want you guys to pay very close attention to when it fires, okay? This is something that I discovered while we were working on our joke episode. Alright. Now watch that block right there. See how far that went? You know, did you notice that as soon as these went off, it's right as soon as this popped up? That's the secret. If you activate it and have that pop up as soon as that fires, not only will it use the force of it popping itself up, but this force, and it will go pretty much the greatest distance that you can go with a cannon this small. Now, I'm going to show you guys exactly how to construct a cannon like this, Vorpal style, in which you can get the greatest distance you can. Alright, before you start working on the cannon, make sure you have plenty of space to work with. The cannon itself is 5x9. I'm going to make sure I've got plenty of space to work with here. So I moved myself 3 away. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll count that as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There we go. We have 5x9. Then, following our template over there, right there, and right there. Okay. Next, from the front side of the cannon, the reason why we made it 5x9 is because we want two barrels with water going the max distance it can. Either give yourself some water blocks like I have here, or use a bucket of water to have it coming all the way down. Note, give commands can only be used on a server. And, by the way guys, just a note, only use give commands if you really feel like you want to, like, you know, just experiment or build, but give commands on single player worlds, it would remove the point of the game. The only reason why you should ever use give commands is when you're experimenting or playing with TNT or something like that. Don't know why I said that. I just figured I'd give my 2 cents on that. Next, on this end of the cannon, you want to cover that side right there, like that, by 2. Make sure that there's still water flowing under there. You don't want to have, like, you know, put the stones down there. That's your source block. You really, really need that water flowing like that. Do not change anything right there. The next thing you want to do is you want to make the very first part of the barrel. Like, well, you want to separate the two chambers into two different barrels. You accomplish this by taking, and this area that you put right here, you pull it all the way out. Make sure you leave room right here, because that's very important, or else your cannon will not fire right or even blow itself up. Next step is from the back end. You want to take those wings and start pulling them out and pull them all the way over the very front end, like so. Make sure you do this on both ends. But make sure you leave a space open in the center, because that's where some of your redstone is going to go. Congratulations! The base of your cannon is finally assembled. This is what it should look like. If it does not look like this, you're doing it wrong, and you should go back, rewind the YouTube video, and watch it over, and make sure that you did everything correctly. Next up, guys, is your wiring. You might want to set up your switch now, just to make sure that everything is all in place. Go ahead and I'll put my switch there. It's a little bit closer than my other one, but nothing's wrong with it. Bring your switch down. Now note, it's going to take a little bit of experimentation, but you're going to have to find exactly where you need to set your redstone repeater for that. Make sure you leave spaces for your repeaters under this part where the wing starts on each side. And also, you must make sure to bring it up through the center. These are used to activate the TNT blocks that you have set up. Next are your repeaters. You want to replace a repeater here, here, and here. Make sure they are set on the default position. Also, placing a redstone repeater right about here would help as well, because it would make sure that your signal extends all the way through to the other side. You want to make sure that when you hit that button, that all of your redstone lines light up. It is very important. Next is probably the single most important part of the cannon, and it is the part that most people might forget. You want to make sure that you line torches all across this, not to keep monsters out, but for another very special reason. These torches here will keep the TNT from popping up, and thus, if it pops up like that, it could cause the cannon to misfire, blow you up, or even blow up your entire contraption. And that, everybody, is the basics of building a standard cannon. While this version of the cannon does indeed work, and I shall show you, this cannon does not work as well as my design over there for one reason. Timing. I'm going to show you guys this. It's fully fireable, but you have to manually fire the ammunition. So if you don't fire it, like, you know, if you don't time it perfectly, it doesn't fire as well. Like, see, it went pretty far. I mean, it went really far, actually. And it actually would have hit the ground had this been lower to the ground, but you guys saw the episode. You know what we were aiming for. But it can go farther. And it's all about timing. And I'm going to show you guys how to build a redstone circuit that, with the click of that button, not only will it light the gunpowder, I guess is what it would call. It will light the TNT that forces the bullet, and it will light your TNT bullet as well. Fail, but whatever. And now, I'm going to show you how to build the timer the timing mechanism, rather. The secret to this... Oh, there's my button. The secret to this is a redstone circuit using 10 of these redstone repeaters. Make sure that when building this, that you have that exact number, and you build it exactly how we're going to show you. Okay. Now, how you want to do this is you want to make sure you give it plenty of room to breathe, because you don't want your redstone interfering with other redstone. Well, you know how redstone is. It's really picky. We set our third. Here's number four. Here's number five. Number six. Make sure they're all set to neutral. Number seven. There's number eight. There's number nine. And there's number 10. There are going to need, you need to make more redstone repeaters to make sure that you can bring the signal all the way up to the front. But I'll tell you more about that later. The only redstone repeaters that don't need to be on the default settings are these. Now, redstone repeaters don't only carry a signal past 15 blocks. They also add delay, if you guys didn't already know that, depending on how much you put in here. Like, for instance, if I press this button, it will delay it just ever slightly before it moves on to the next series. And then it all goes all the way down like that. The secret is 9 out of 10 of these must be all the way up. And the 10th and final on the second to last setting. 1-2 clicks. Not at 3. 1-2. Like that. And that is the correct timing to make sure that your TNT block goes off as soon as it pops up. Alright guys, remember how I said make sure you give yourself plenty of room? I screwed up a little bit at the beginning of this video. I didn't give myself enough room here to make sure that I could arm all three of these sides. So I had to end up taking this little wiring setup right here and moving it a little bit to the right. So always make sure that you give yourself more room that you think you need, especially working with redstone, because the small redstone is really, really finicky, and even at the smallest thing that is different could make all the difference, and you don't want to screw up, especially with cannons. Now for the last bit, guys, is the part that actually ignites the ammunition. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I always make sure I put down 12 because, well, I like to have that leeway because I know it's not the perfect amount, but that also, like, you know, it I don't know. It just makes sure that, you know, nothing can go wrong just in case I need to, like, you know, expand it, or if I could even make it smaller in the future. Now, guys, you want to make sure that all this redstone, that since this is the part that activates your ammo, that the redstone, the circuit that you made, is pointing individually at these three blocks right here. The center, the left, and the right. Because these three areas are the three areas that you will be placing your ammo, depending on how you want to aim it. And there you are, guys. Your Vorpal Cannon is completed. You want to make sure that when you press this button before you load it with any TNT, that signal is given up here, and in due time, that signal comes up over here, and it is given to each of these three blocks. Now, I'm going to double check. Everything is working perfectly. And if I didn't screw up, and this should work perfectly. This is how you load it. This is for max power. You put two under there, under each one. That means 8 TNT total on each side. Then you put your 17th piece of TNT right there. That's a lot of TNT, guys. That's a lot of creepers. See why we had to cheat for that joke episode? Because, well, yeah. Okay. Here we go. This is this version of the Vorpal Cannon's first fire. Let's hope it doesn't glitch. It's probably gonna glitch, but it'll fire correctly, I'm sure. Whoa! Oh, wow. I'm sure that exploded in the air. Let's give it another fire with longer draw distance. All right, guys, here we go. Second shot. Max draw distance. Graphics set on fast, and first one level of fog to reduce the chance of crashing. Here we go. Fire number two. That is a nice cannon. I am proud of this. Now note, guys, if you increase the time that it would fire right here, if you mess with these at all and make the delay even longer, the chances of you blowing yourself and your cannon up increase. However, if you make the time that this that these up here activate shorter, meaning the signal gets to it quicker, you can make it fire less far. You can also experiment with angles and stuff and power, depending on how much TNT you put on each side, if you put TNT on a side at all, whether or not you just do it lightly, all on one side, only one layer, put it more heavily up front here, or even just fully load one side, have one side halfway full, and even just have that right there. Experiment with that, and you can get this going as far. Glitch, that didn't actually blow up. See? You can have that going as far as you want on any direction, or as short as you want, depending on how you have the timing set up. Just experiment. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. This is Vorpal, signing out. Oh, before I go, if you guys want to, we would love it if you guys would post video responses to this video showing us how you have made your own Vorpal Cannon, and perhaps showing off how you guys, like, you know, just like you firing it. Maybe you could make some giant targets, like, you know, target practice if you want. Maybe, like, you know, shooting at different angles. Who knows? Just have fun with it. But, yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this. This is Vorpal Blade, signing out.